Hi there, in today's video we're gonna talk about the Dutch roll. The target of today's video is to make sure you understand what the Dutch roll is and what happened when you faced the Dutch roll. We're gonna look at some very basic aerodynamics knowledge that you need to have in order to understand the Dutch roll, and then we're gonna jump into the whiteboard in order to make a practical example and make sure you understand in full this phenomena. Okay, so without further ado, let's jump right into it. If you are new to the channel, welcome. If you are not new, welcome back. My name is Gabriele and I help you to become a better pilot. So if this is what you want to do, please consider subscribe. If you want to support the channel, give it a like to the video because this is very important for me. Alright, so let's talk about the Dutch roll. Before talking what happened on the Dutch roll, we need to understand what is the lateral stability and the directional stability of the plane. Okay, so the lateral stability is the tendency of the aircraft to go back to the previous state after an outside disturbance or a pilot's input. What I mean by that, okay, so for example, the lateral stability is your roll stability, okay? The roll of the plane, as we saw already in previous video, is this movement here, okay? It's your movement around your longitudinal axis, okay? An aircraft that has got a roll stability, a lateral stability, okay, is very good because let's say you roll to the left or you roll to the right and the aircraft will naturally go back to the previous state. So let's say you are actually flying in a level flight, you roll to the right, okay, and yeah, if you leave the control, the aircraft will naturally go back to its previous status. Okay, so if I can show you from this point here, the aircraft is flying, you roll to the left, and then you leave the controls, the aircraft goes back naturally. This is when you've got an aircraft that is lateral stable, okay? An aircraft that is unstable laterally, okay, it's got a roll instability. What will happen is that if you roll to the right, okay, and you leave the controls, the aircraft doesn't go back to its previous state, but what actually it does, it continues rolling all the way down. That's an unstable because it doesn't go back to the previous state. An aircraft that normally is called neutral stable is that if you roll to the right, okay, you leave the controls, the aircraft will stay in the position, the new position, the new state, okay? So as you can see, the stability of the plane is very important, okay? So the aircraft, in order to understand in full the Dutch roll, we need to make sure that we talked about the directional stability and the lateral stability. Okay, the directional stability of the plane is the stability that basically takes, if you fly, let's say, straight and you yaw to the left or yaw to the right and you leave the pedals, okay, you release the pedal pressure, the aircraft will go back to this previous state. Okay, so an aircraft that is has got a big directional stability will actually go back to its previous state very quickly. Okay, an aircraft that has got a directional stability, a big directional stability, we have this tendency to go back. Okay, so now I can say that the Dutch roll is a mixture of an aircraft that has got a swept back wings. Okay, first of all, the swept back wings are these wings that, as you can see, they go back. The leading edge has got this arrow. Okay, if you compare the wing to a Cessna, you will see the difference. Okay, so an aircraft that has got swept back wings and is a mixed lateral and the directional stability will produce this Dutch roll moment. Okay, so let's talk about actually what it is, this Dutch roll. Okay, so an aircraft that is flying straight, okay, and then suddenly turn to the right, it goes into the roll to the right, let's say, okay, what will happen is gonna be something like this. So this is the movement of a Dutch roll, okay, and if you don't do anything, okay, normally the jet planes like the Boeing 737 will recover itself. So normally you don't really need to touch because if the aircraft is stable enough, it will correct itself, okay? We have a system on board that's called yaw damper that actually we help to counteract the Dutch roll, which is the movement of the aircraft combining the yawing and the rolling, okay? And now in a few seconds, we're gonna jump into the whiteboard and I will show you how does this happen, okay? So as we said, this Dutch roll is applicable to the swept back wings, okay? Like in this case, the Boeing 737, as you can see, this is the angle, okay? The swept back aircraft. But why is it applicable to this type of aircraft? So let's bear with me. This is very important that you understand that the aircraft, when it's flying straight, it's gonna have a relative airflow that goes over the aircraft. Okay, the relative airflow is the airflow, let's say, a day without any wind. The relative airflow is the airflow that goes over the aircraft, because the aircraft is actually going forward. Okay, but when you turn, this is crucial to understand in order to see the Dutch roll. Okay, when you bend to the right, when you roll to the right, the aircraft will go into this side slip. Okay, so it's gonna do something like that, this movement. Okay, this movement of the aircraft will create an airflow, a relative airflow, that is gonna be normal to the leading edge of your wing. So it's gonna be perpendicular to the leading edge of the going down wing. So when you bend to the right, the aircraft will produce this side slip. Okay, this side slip is this movement. By producing this movement, okay, there will be a relative airflow that will arrive perpendicular to this wing, to the down, to the wing that is actually going down. Because by doing this movement, you will see that there will be a relative airflow that will touch perpendicular to this area, the leading edge of your right wing in this case. Okay. However, if you look at the relative airflow on the side slip, okay, you will see that here is perpendicular, but here is not. Okay, so what will happen is that by having a perpendicular airflow on the wing that went down due to the roll to the right, okay, this wing will create more lift, because you're gonna have more airflow coming into the wing, okay? And that's why it's applicable to the swept-back wings, okay? Because of this angle, when you create a side slip, okay? Because of this angle, the wing will actually get this perpendicular airflow. Fantastic. So now, since this wing that went down after creating this side slip, there will be more lift here. So every more lift, the wing will tend to go up again. And that's why this type of aircraft has roll stable, okay? It has got a lateral stability, okay? Because if you turn to the right, if you bend to the right, then you release the controls, the aircraft will automatically go back. Why? Because by turning to the right, it's gonna go into this side slip. This side slip will produce this relative airflow perpendicular to your wing. This wing is gonna produce more lift because of this relative airflow, thus going back and put you back to the level flight. Okay, beautiful. But let's see. Okay, we turn to the right, the aircraft do this side slip, the relative airflow will go on the leading edge, more lift is created, but as you know, when you create more lift, you create more drag. Okay, when you create more drag, so this wing actually, what will happen is that since you're creating more drag and more lift, this wing will do something like that. So you're gonna have a yo moment as well. So what will happen is that you start bent to the right, side slip, relative airflow, more lift and more drag, thus you're gonna do something like that. Okay, now that we know that by creating this side slip, we produce more lift and more drag, what will happen is the following, okay? We need to understand that in the case of the Boeing 737, normally the aircraft that are subject to this Dutch roll, they have a big roll stability compared to the lateral stability. So they are very fast to go back to the wing level state, but they are not so fast to correct the yaw tendency. Okay, so if you are yawing and then you go back, this is the directional stability. Okay, so the aircraft that are subject to the Dutch roll, they have a lateral stability that is higher than directional stability. Okay, so this is very important, because when the aircraft start to roll to the right, it's gonna go down, create this relative airflow. You're gonna have more lift and more drag. Thus, this will do something like that. However, since you've got more drag in here, this wing will have a slower speed compared to the other wing. Thus, the aircraft will start a yaw, okay? By starting a yaw, since the aircraft is directional and lateral stable, we try to actually correct the yaw. So the aircraft, suddenly you will see that it's gonna turn to the left. And since the lateral stability is higher, the aircraft will start to bang in the opposite direction, creating this effect of going on side slip. Thus, you're gonna have more airflow here, you're gonna produce more lift, and the opposite is you're gonna have a yaw moment. Then the aircraft, since it's lateral and directional stable, is gonna do the same, okay? So an aircraft that is stable will actually correct itself, okay? But normally, again, we have the yaw damper system on board that will actually change the fin, okay? It's gonna make a rudder movement in order to make sure that this doesn't happen, okay? So I hope you now a little bit get what is and the idea and what you really need to know. Now we jump into the whiteboard and we do the practical example in order to make sure that it's clear 100%. Right, guys, so welcome to the whiteboard, okay? It is very important you bear with me because now we're gonna do this practical example. As you can see on the left, we've got an anchor from the top, and then we've got three different stage of the Dutch roll, okay? So let's start. As you can see, right turn, okay, we bank to the right, as you can see in the picture number one in here, okay, what will happen? Because you're banking to the right, you're going to this side slip to the right. Thus, you're creating an airflow, a relative airflow that is actually going perpendicular to your leading edge, okay? Because if this is the relative airflow, as you can see, the relative airflow on the left wing is not perpendicular, but on the right wing, because of the swept back type of wings, okay, you're gonna have this perpendicular airflow. This perpendicular airflow will create more lift on the wing that is going down. So in this wing in here, okay, so you're gonna have a lift vector, okay, that is actually bigger than the left wing, okay? Fantastic. This is the right wing has got a lift vector desire because the relative airflow is perpendicular because of the side slip that we actually talked about, okay? So what will happen is now the following. Since you're creating more lift, okay, the lift desire, however, the drag as well went up, okay? So if the drag went up, what will happen is that this wing, okay, the wing that is producing more lift now, after that we bank to the right, we start going to this side slip, it's gonna produce the drag, so it's gonna start to go slower compared to the left wing. Okay, so the wing on the right, since it's producing more lift, it's producing more drag, thus slowing. This slower speed on the right wing will actually produce the yaw. Okay? Beautiful. So now, as you can see, the aircraft is banking to the right, going to this side slip and producing this yaw to the right. Okay, fantastic. So now that we've got this yaw to the right, okay, what will happen to your relative airflow? That's gonna come like this. Okay, so the relative airflow will come like this. What will happen is that you're gonna produce, let me do it clear, you're gonna produce a angle of attack, a higher angle of attack, because this is your airflow, okay, on your rudder, okay? So if you look at your rudder in here, okay, the rudder is like a wing, okay? So if you've got an angle of attack because of the yaw that we saw before, okay, so if you produce an angle of attack on your rudder, what will happen is that the rudder will actually produce the lift, because you can see that you have to look at the rudder like a wing. So if you produce an angle of attack with your relative airflow because you yaw to the right, okay, this rudder will actually create a lift that will yaw back to the left, okay? So but after creating this yaw to the right, so after that the rudder is created, the lift to the right, okay, what will happen is that the aircraft will yaw back to the left, okay? Beautiful. So now, guys, again, let me do a quick review because this is very important, okay? So you bank to the right, example number one. Let's do it again, okay? By banking to the right, you go into this side slip that we talked about, creating a relative airflow on the wing that is going down. In this case, the right wing, okay? Because this will be your relative airflow when you actually bank to the right. So because this relative airflow is here to the leading edge, you will produce more lift. So this wing, the right wing, is gonna produce more lift, okay, after you banked and your relative airflow arrived on your leading edge, than the left wing. Thus, you're gonna have the aircraft to level off again to go into the level flight, okay, straight levels, okay? Wings level, okay? But because you're producing more lift, you're producing also more drag. Thus, since you produce more drag, this wing will slow down compared to the left wing. So the right wing will slow down compared to the left wing. Thus, creating a right yaw, okay? A yaw to the right, okay? But by creating a yaw to the right, guys, it is very important that we actually understand that by yawing to the right, okay, if let's say this is the relative airflow on a straight level flight, no problem, okay, you're not touching anything, so you're going forward and that's your relative airflow, wings level and everything. But if you yaw to the right, what will happen is that the nose will go to the right. Thus, the relative airflow, if you yaw to the right, okay, yaw to the right, all right, the relative airflow will come like that, all right? Because you are yawing to the right, okay? So if you come like that, the relative airflow will actually hit your rudder and get you an angle of attack. Okay, by creating this angle of attack, okay, you're gonna produce lift. Okay, so the rudder will produce lift, and this lift, what will happen is that will make your rudder go to the right, the tail of the plane going to the right, thus the nose go back to the left, and thus correcting this yaw to the right. Okay, so I hope this is clear. This is crucial in order to understand. So what will happen is that, let's go back. We turn right. More lift, more drag, we yaw to the right, the aircraft correct with a yaw to the left, the wing is back up, but because the aircraft that has got this Dutch roll problem, they have the lateral stability, the tendency of go back on the roll stability is higher than the directional stability. What will happen is that the aircraft will actually bank to the left. Okay, so will bank to the left, thus creating again the left wing in this case is gonna go down. By going down, you're gonna have the relative airflow now going perpendicular to the left wing, thus creating the same effect all over again. You're gonna have more airflow to the left wing, thus creating more lift, thus creating more drag. The left wing will slow down compared to the right wing, and then you're gonna have the yaw to the left, and then the rudder will correct the yaw to the right, to the left, and so on. Okay, so as you can see, guys, the Dutch roll is a mixture of lateral stability and directional stability. But because the aircraft that are affected by the Dutch roll have a lateral stability that is higher than directional stability, they are faster on correcting the roll than the yaw. What will happen is that there will be this mixture of the aircraft trying to correct the yaw and the roll all together, thus creating these oscillations, this strange roll and yaw moment all together at the same time. Okay, so then we've got the yaw damper that actually will move, will make small movement on the rudder, and in order to correct this dash roll. Okay, so guys, it is very important that if you have any questions throughout the video, leave a comment below and then I will help you out. Also, go to pilotclient.com where you can subscribe for free pilot training content. I wish you a great day and I'll see you in the next one.